Mad Wolf here, and this is gonna be another rant video. Really haven't been feeling too good lately, and kind of upset about some things. One thing I'm gonna rant about is YouTube, because once again, some of our videos, Arctic's and mine, Arctic's at work, by the way, have had copyright claims on them. Now, yeah, like the Yakety Sax one, I could understand that. I could legitimately understand that. I use Yakety Sax for 30 minutes. The Star Fox one, way back in the day when I first got a Wii U, no, I don't understand that at all. I got a copyright strike from Nintendo just because I was playing their game. Not sure what the hell was up with that. The latest one really upset me. I was playing Omicron the Nomad Soul for the Sega Dreamcast, which does feature music by David Bowie. David Bowie himself is in the game. He's one of the reasons why I shot the tribute, or shot the video. When I originally did it, it was going to be a tribute video, like right when he passed away, and I was going to kind of do it like a memorial thing, but I lost the footage. So I reshot it, and I uploaded it to YouTube. No, apparently some greedy corporation, a music record company, is upset that I used their music in a video. It's the music in the opening credits of the game. So yeah, if they have an issue with me using their music, maybe they shouldn't have uploaded it in the damn game. Or allowed the company to upload it in the game. Basically, the fault is on the game, not me, just for playing the game. Another complaint I have is, you guys probably seen I haven't been doing much artisticness videos. OBS Studio has been crashing on me every time I've been trying to record footage from the computer screen. Once again, going back to, this is why I don't use OBS Studio to record Wolfenstein 3. Because shit is unstable. It won't work. The last time I shot a video, I got like an hour of footage recorded painting something. And then it's like, oh, we can't save the file because we decided to crash on you. Yay, thank you. Speaking of things not working, let me show you something. I typed up a review for Double Dragon 4. See, I'm not sure if you guys can see it. Yeah, here it is here. I click the submit button. One more step. Please complete the security check to access webs.com. Okay. I'm not a robot. Yay, I've been verified. Redirecting, please wait. Goes back to the forums. Updated 2 weeks ago. What the hell is going on here? I go into games. And there's no Double Dragon 4. So I have no idea what is going on there. Yeah. Kind of pissed about that one, because I bought Double Dragon 4 off of PlayStation Network. It took me all night to download it. My internet's really not that good right now. I played it. I've been liking it. You know, for $7, it's a pretty good brawler game, because, I mean, they haven't made Double Dragon in an actual Double Dragon game since Double Dragon 5 at Shadow Falls, and that was a tournament game, so it wasn't really a Double Dragon game. The one before that was Super Double Dragon for Super Nintendo, which is kind of like the real Double Dragon 4. They made some other Double Dragon games for Xbox Live, but I don't know, for some reason it just doesn't feel like Double Dragon to me. It feels like a pair. It feels like one is Double Dragon Neon. It kind of feels like a joke. It opens up with Marion getting punched and being hauled off, and they're like, Marion, oh, not again. And it's like, Yeah, it happened again. In this one, they kind of do it again, and I even made a joke about that in the review. Let's see if I can punch that back up. Let's see. Chief enemy, blah, 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 blah. Okay, yeah. Billy's girlfriend Marion is punched in the stomach and hauled off by some bad dudes in a screen almost ripped directly from the original Double Dragon on NES. Go, Double Dragon, save the damsel in distress who dresses like a... Yeah. She does. Dress like a whore. So yeah, I've been trying to get that uploaded. And, you know, I think that's a pretty funny joke. Because she keeps doing it. And she keeps getting in trouble. But yeah, I can't upload the review, apparently, for some reason, which pisses me off. Might try again tonight. Another thing that's pissed me off lately is this game here. I just bought this at GameStop. No issues with the people at GameStop. I really like the people at the local GameStop. But For Honor for the PS4. I've been really looking forward to this game for a long time because it sounded hella cool. And whenever I looked at the bat, or whenever I took the case out of the bag, my first words were, uh-oh, because online connection required. Now, supposedly there's a single player mode in the game. So why the hell do I need online to play single player on a PS4 game? That doesn't make any sense. I mean, even Quake 3 Arena, you don't have to connect online to play single player. Now, I realize I kind of defended Diablo 3 because I said, hey, you know, here's an option. You can get the console version, you don't have to go online. This you have to go online for, and this is the console version. The best part is, I can't even do that. Because first things first, the game's been out for, 2 days? And it's already up to version 1.02, which is a 4 GB patch. Yeah, I'm going to have to wait until 2 o'clock in the morning tonight to try to download this. Because right now, my internet is super slow. Joys of having a bandwidth cap and not being part of modern day technology. So yeah, it's a giant pain in the ass. Finally, and this is going full circle, gonna bitch about YouTube some more. This time I'm actually gonna chew out some people on YouTube. Not sure about naming names, but as you guys probably know, I did a rant on video about Resident Evil 7, and a lot of people have given me flack for, oh my god, you're a dick because you don't like Resident Evil 7, you're not scared of it. No, I'm really not. I'm more annoyed with it. Jack is an annoying character. He's not scary at all. The chainsaw battle with him actually kind of feels awesome because you're having like a chainsaw fight. And that does not sound scary at all. It just, it's like a Doom thing. I'm armed with a chainsaw. He has a double chainsaw. And it even opens with an Evil Dead joke. So no, I'm really not scared of that. Besides which, early on in the game, I had my hand chopped off with the chainsaw anyway. So I'm like, oh yeah, chainsaws are not that big of a deal in this game. There's a lot of reasons why I don't think the game's scary. And Arctic and I actually did shoot a Time to Play episode of Resident Evil 7 showing how non-scared we were at the game. We actually had a legitimate jump scare when we first played the game. And that's a specific scene. Mia pops out from a corner and she's all like, it's okay, it's okay, baby. And yeah, of course you're gonna get jumped from that. It's a jump scare. Another thing is everyone's all like attacking me for, you know, I don't know what he's talking about. It's a scary game. It's full of jump scares. You know, first of all, I was never really scared of Resident Evil to begin with. I mean, let that sink in. Everyone's like, oh yeah, Resident Evil 7, it's going back to its roots. I never was scared of Resident Evil. Maui Cowie wants to say hi. My sister used to have jump scares at specific scenes in Resident Evil. I kind of described that in the Time to Play episode of Resident Evil Code Veronica X. And when it happened, I used to kind of make fun of her. I'd be like, "You didn't see that coming like a mile away? Come on." And my thoughts with Resident Evil 7, I'm gonna finish this up. I'll get into my thoughts in a second. The thing that bugs me about YouTube, those YouTube guys defending Resident Evil 7, the funny thing is they're attacking me on the Rant On video. They're saying, "Oh no." And there's people that agree with me. I don't necessarily agree with them agreeing with me because they're just like, "It's not scary." That doesn't mean it's not a good game. It's actually really interesting setting and storyline. I don't think they should have slapped the Resident Evil name on it, because there's only two little details in that whole game that really kind of connected to the Resident Evil universe, and taking those two things out would have been its own game. And I think the developers just kind of did that to try to make sure it grabs your attention. And it did. A lot of people were, a lot of Resident Evil fans wanted it. The game got a lot of attention, for good or worse. I personally don't think it's a bad game. I actually kind of think it's a pretty interesting mystery in today's day and age. But I'm not into the jump scare games. I'm like, "Yeah, okay, you're just kind of throwing that out there because it's like textbook. How do we scare people? Throw in a jump scare. Have something pop up." I had a jump scare playing a Wolfenstein 3D mod. Hell, I still have jump scares playing Wolfenstein 3D. So it really doesn't have to be high definition graphics or anything like that to make it work. There you are, Cowie. But what upsets me is we did a Time to Play episode of Resident Evil 7, and the funny thing is, not one person has viewed it yet. Within a day of that Rant On video, we've had like 100 views. I'm gonna see if I can pull it up really quick because I gotta rant about something else. Yeah, within like a day, we've had over 100 views, and not that I really care so much about views, but I do think it's funny that everyone's defending this game or attacking this game, and yet they don't actually watch us play the game and watch how we react to the game, watch what we think of the game. And matter of fact, yeah, there's the screen right there. No views. Hell, Quackshot has more views than Resident Evil 7. This great game that just came out, and no one seems interested on people playing it. They seem more interested in people talking about it. And for me, I'm like, that's kind of dumb. I mean, I can understand you guys are defending your game you really like, but if you're not going to legitimately look at why this guy has views the way they are, then yeah, it's kind of dumb. Yeah, our Rant On video of Resident Evil, up to 204 views. Now, that's over 3 weeks old, but I'm not kidding. Within a day, it jumped to like 70 to 100, and I'm not really exactly sure why, but maybe the video is too long. I mean, things are just really in a weird position right now, and I really don't agree with a lot of stuff going on online. I don't agree with society, some of the things society's going on about. It's a lot of extremes on both sides, but honestly, I just want shit to work right now. That's my main thing is, corporations monetizing Arctics in my videos because, oh, there's a 2 minute song in there from a game that we authorized the song to be in the game. So, of course, people are going to play it. Of course, people are going to want to share it. For me, monetizing someone else's videos so you can get money on your product or whatever it is, it's not cutting down on cyber piracy or stopping the people publicly uploading movies and stuff like that, what it's doing is pissing people like me off, because it's like, well, you're getting money for my face playing this game and sung by David Bowie, but your corporation owns the song. So that's great. You guys can sit on your butts and basically do nothing. An artist can sing, a talented artist can sing a song, and, you know, we can't even share a video to kind of share his memory because, well, we need money. You know, there's a reason why I don't monetize my videos, and that's part of the reason why I don't agree with, oh, I need money for what I'm doing. I encourage people to support me on Patreon, but it's not a requirement. And, I don't know, this is just really messed up. The fact that I have tools that aren't working, the fact that I have a website not working, the fact that corporations are basically monetizing our videos because of petty stuff I think is petty. Why is an Accolade putting a copyright strike on Slave Zero? I think it's made by... No, it's Infogrames, my bad. Infogrames, however you pronounce it, they did Slave Zero, okay? Why is Yakety Sax the subject of copyright there? Why isn't the game? Why isn't this particular camera that I'm using? Why isn't, I don't know, the state of California saying, oh no, you live in a house, so we're going to put a copyright strike on you, whatever. And then it's like, oh no, well, things are also not going to work. So, anyway, that's my rant. Take for what it is. Yeah, I was really looking forward to playing this too. And kind of upsetting. Anyway, guys, have a good one.